28 workers on Crossrail working for BFK in Westbourne Park were sacked. They are members of the Unite Trade Union. One was a shop steward for Unite, one was an health and safety rep. A couple of weeks after that, there was an accident on Westbourne Park that could have killed workers on that site. BFK do not want trade union members on their site, but trade unions keep people with decent pay, decent terms and conditions, and help to get safe construction sites. We are doing this today because Crossrail is the biggest project currently in London. It has billions and billions of public money, and yet despite all that, they are allowed to get away with treating workers like this.
Move it from here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Move it from here.
Get out of here. Who are you?
You're not gonna play, bro.
Get out.
Yo, yo, right. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
This is a public hour.
So I do here.
Get up.
Sonny, let's just leave and see it. Leave the public.
Come on, man.
Come on, man.
Go on. Do your talk.
Appreciate, you know, play your music.
Yeah,
it was
work,
then,
no, it's fine.
Just embarrassing. Okay, thank you for moving over.
We're not here to cause. I told him not to
cause
problems. We're here to embarrass.
Well, yeah, okay.
And that's it.
And that's,
no, you should never do it.
No, absolutely. Thank you very much. As long as pedestrians can get past and traffic can get through.
Yeah,
and that's,
I see, why not?
Excellent. Thank you very much. If you need anything, then just give one of us a shout. Yeah, I'll give you one of those.
Reports that the delays to the tunnelling, TfL are putting it as £30 million a day. And that's basically because not only the contributing factors of 6 weeks delay hitting the targets, hitting the targets to meet the other stations on the bill, but you can't run a tube network unless your tunnels are finished. Security are becoming a lot more aggressive. Last Friday, I pulled up my usual spot. They decided to barry it off. I tried to park on the other side of the barrier. As I was reversing back, the security guard started kicking the back of the van. Then he started punching the side of the van. And after he finished doing that, he pulled open the door and he says, "Oh, you're a smart effer, you are. I'll finish you at 7, I'm going to do you." And he started throwing all my banners into the road. They called the police and the security guard made allegations that I tried to run him over. Then they tried to clamp the van. Clamping has been banned since October on private land. It's not even on their property. We've got permission off the bus managers in here. They said we've no problem here. It's not your property. It's on the top of the park.
You've got no right to clamp.
I just
right,
think.
You're breaking the law.
Just
think. I don't care what you think. You're breaking the law.
If you clamp me, you're breaking the law. I've given you a warning. If you're on camera,
don't care.
I'll
clamp you.
Deeper into the sound, life goes on.
clear stops of lorries coming into the project.
We are some drivers, picky line, they just don't. Fine, we're not going to push them. There's no.
But we haven't got problems on this sort of people.
Yeah, no, we are people. I'll give him a leaflet. I think it's nice when you're not stopping. He goes, Tony's injured.
So, well, yeah.
Then we said, go on, you better go in. They sacked us all to be raised safety issues on the site, and because we're operating a blacklist on the site. That's why we only want our jobs back. That's all we're here. As soon as it gives us jobs back, we'll go.
Exactly. In the current climate at the moment, everyone wants to work.
They're trying to tap my van. My van's on private property. I've got permission from there. It's against the law from October to tamper vehicles. And they're just saying, well, we're going to tamper your van. I said, well, it's not on your property, though. We don't care.
Well, it won't be them
that
clamped it anyway, it'd be the council or the
police.
So
well,
if we have a problem with it,
they'll
be fine.
Look, there's their clamp.
The call we got was a lot of protesters. Obviously, there's not a lot.
No,
but the call we got was a lot of protesters obstructing the lorries and pushing people around. That's why we turned up.
No.
Obviously, lawful protest is something we don't really worry about.
Please do not cross the picket! Please do not cross the picket!
Move! Keep moving!
Out!
These people are blocking up and causing trouble.
What about the safety hazard of getting rid of a shop steward and health and safety steward?
Where's
the Chihuahua?
Got through, they got the job.
I'm trying to hand the leaflets to the lorries and they're just assaulting me. They don't like it because I'm exposing their blacklist. That's what they don't like. They don't like the fact that I've exposed Ron Barron. Ron Barron is the senior HR director of Crossrail. The man in charge of industrial relations of Crossrail is a senior man in the consultant association, the blacklisting organisation. That's what Crossrail's agenda is all about. They know exactly what they've been doing. I'm sick of getting assaulted. Every day I'm assaulted about 10, 15 times. So if they want to assault me, they're going to have to get dirty.
order.
Disappeared for 10 minutes, they threw all my banners all over the road, bent my flagpoles, and they just assessed the banners. These banners, I have them tied to the bridge for safety. There's no doubt in my mind that they tried to rip them into the road. Because they couldn't rip them into the road, they done this thing and just slashed them. As you can see, they've just slashed the names. They don't want their names on the banners, so all the flags have been stolen as well. So.
No, why would I do that? I haven't got
why enough. Am I hearing this?
What's going on? You're on camera doing it.
The bus inspector's seen you do it.
He's got me on camera.
You've got a knife out and you slashed it.
He's got me on camera.
And what have you stood here for all day if you didn't see anything?
What's the buses?
This is going to be raised with your employers, mate. Don't worry about that.
There we go.
But as I was saying, he assaulted me twice this week, so I'm discharging him now. He's assaulted me, got him on video assaulting me, so I'm criminal damage and assault. They might rip the banners, but the message stays the same.
Offices of the rail regulators. They're the organisation in charge of health and safety across the entire rail industry. We're going to go inside and try and ask if we can speak to some of the directors. We've got a democratic right to protest. All we're asking for is to be able to talk to one of the directors from the Office of Rail Regulators.
Yeah.
All we're asking for is a very simple request.
Please.
Can you make your way out? Has been passed on to one of the senior managers in the Office of Rail Regulators, and they're now discussing which one of them is going to come down and talk to us.
After the protest started, we got invited in by the Office of Rail Regulator, and we've got their card, very good. We spoke to Tom Wake, is the Principal Inspector of Railways and the Director of Rail Safety. And we also spoke to Graham Richards, who's the Deputy Director of Rail Planning and Performance. And me and Frank had a 15-minute private conversation with them about what's been going on Crossrail, about what's taking place with the health and safety reps in Crossrail. What they said to us is, 2 weeks ago in St Pancras, the Office of Rail Regulator organised a big conference about how trade unions are an invaluable asset in improving health and safety in the rail industry. And they were very, very interested in all the stuff we told them about what was going on with BFK and Crossrail.
They were going to raise questions with Crossrail and contact BFK, and they've asked for further information about myself, about what's happening, so I'll be supplying that.
Did they say when they were going to do that?
Oh, they were very interested.
Yeah.
Very interested.